then Mr. Eichip. I think it's Victor Eichip.
Thank you. I'm John Brockett. I live 17 and a half miles from Indian Point. Scares me every day outside. There's a water plume, heat plume in the river. It's documented with infrared. I'd love to see that material. 800,000 gallons a minute being drawn in from river and sent out once, heat. Entergy's reaping from the public water. Heating water like that is disrupting the environment. It is not natural. I want to clarify one thing. They talked about asthma. You look at the basic fact on asthma, it's a nutritional deficiency. The diet, the standard American diet has deteriorated in the United States, and people's immune systems aren't working right. What is a hard fact is that the incidence of leukemia in children in Westchester County is 26% higher than non-nuclear plant areas. Another fact, the radionuclides in mother's milk, the closer you get to Indian Point, the higher the radionuclides. Now, if I were a young woman, young mother, that would make me mad as hell that I couldn't nurse my child because of radiation from Indian Point. DEC is simply trying to uphold what Indian Point was supposed to do 35 years ago and put in closed cycle nuclear, closed cycle cooling. This is nothing new. If Entergy is scared because they can't do it fast enough, it's their problem. Because Indian Point was supposed to have closed cycle 35 years ago. And I applaud DEC for finally having the guts to stand up and saying we're going to uphold the Clean Water Act. Entergy's problem with the timing is their own fault. And on jobs, how many people will be employed in building those cooling towers or whatever kind of closed cycle nuclear? It will be a huge number of jobs. So if you're talking about jobs, the closed cycle nuclear, closed cycle cooling makes a lot of sense. I applaud DEC for upholding the Clean Water Act, and I hope you will stand by it.